Give it up, give it up, give it up.
No! What's up?
Hey, stand up, stand up, stand up. We're gonna do a little some stretches for you.
Let's go!
So we're gonna start off the left. Alright, left. Alright, yeah, we're gonna get right. We're gonna get ready for today. Alright, Krista.
Alright, you can take a seat, settle down. Thank you so much. Alright, welcome to our CIAU Sunday!
Sail the Lord! When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard against him. I see the enemy coming in like a flood. Churches and our families, but what I don't see is the standard. People of
It's a good day to be young. Yeah. Come on, come on, come on. Amen, amen. I want to welcome you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We're so excited to have you join us this Sunday for CIA Youth. For watching online, I want to welcome you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. For inside this house, we want to welcome you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Hope that the will of God is there in your heart in your place.
Yes.
Our scripture for CIA youth is Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11.
Hallelujah.
For I know the thought yes. that I think toward
yes.
you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil,
Hallelujah.
To give you a future and a hope.
Amen.
The word hope in the Bible, it means to have confidence.
Yes.
It's acting the promises of God in our life.
Yes.
And there's promise behind giving. There's hope behind giving.
Yes.
Why do we give? We give because we obey the word of God.
Yes.
Secondly, we give because we expect the promises of God. The book of Malachi, chapter 3, verse 10 says, bring out a tithe into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. And join me now in this, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you such blessing that there will not be room enough to receive it. The promise of God, when we bring our tithe, our giving, to the storehouse, to the house of God, the windows of heaven, there is a windows in heaven that God brought out such blessing that you and I, that is promise, you and I won't have enough room to collect His blessing. That is the promise. There is the hope of why we give. Because we obey the word of God. Secondly, because there is hope in giving. Our giving does not go in vain.
Hey everyone, my name is Malia.
And I'm Vine, and today we'll be announcing the programs for this week.
But before we get into it, could I get you all to say, in the church, we're all fam.
Oh, come on, church, come on.
Say it louder. In the church, we're all fam.
In the church, we're all fam.
Like, could I get you to say it in a Texas accent? Come on, church.
In the church, we're all fam.
When I say Jesus, you say power. Jesus.
Power.
Jesus.
Power.
When I say Jesus, you say power. Jesus.
Power.
Jesus.
Power.
On Wednesday, we will be having word study, so come along and join us as we hear the word of God.
And this Friday, no youth! Yeah! So guys, feel free to enjoy your Friday. And this Saturday, we have Kingdom Fighters 6 a.m. sharp, so come ready and warm. And
this Sunday, we'll be having King's Kids at 9 a.m. and church service kicking off at 11 a.m.
Yeah. Yeah,
thanks.
You did not create me to worry. You did not create me to fear. But you created me to worry. Daily, so I'ma leave it all right here. Help me say yeah.
You did not create me to worry.
Oh.
You did not. Again, if you wonder if this is your first time seeing this scene here, and then you realize this is what young people is all about, is the energy, the passion, and if you feel old, I encourage you, come to our youth, and I'm telling you, you're gonna walk out young. No, it's so great to be in the house of God. I'm trying to find my spiritual balance here, because some of the dance move here was so great, was boom, bang on, was good. You know, but it's so good to be in the house of God. You know, today we celebrate our young people. You know, this year we've worked hard, we have believed for a great generation. You know, one of the words that I like to use, that this is the greatest generation that the world will ever witness. Because God is going to raise up warriors, fearing God woman, fearing God man, to change the city. And I believe for that. And I'm just so excited to be in the house of God. That's all. I'm just so excited to be in the house of God. But you all know the man of God that's going to preach the message, he's a fine man. He's a young man. You know, he's got the hairstyle that many of us don't have. You know, many of us don't have this hairstyle. And he is He is well known in this house, in Gateway to Glory. He has a passion. He has a heart for the church. He loves this church. I'm telling you, I don't know anyone that I know that really has this heart like this young man here. You know, he's so passionate for the young people. And one thing, I know we've been talking about submit, but I want to ask this question. Who does the submit? Is it the man or the woman? Who does it? But I'm pretty sure that we heard on our word study that it's I'm not talking about his submit. I'm talking about his submit to the word of God. He submit to the house. See, all of you guys are looking at this. He's a fine, great man of God. I want to ask everyone to rise to your feet as I introduce our speaker. Introducing a great man of God. 6 feet tall. 90 pounds. Please put your hands together and welcome David Aiga.
All right. Woo-hoo. You may take your seats. Praise God. Can we have the lights on, please? I just want to see everyone. So good to be here this morning. It's an honor. It's an honor to be here. It's an honor to serve you, the Word of God. It's an honor to serve God and His people and also His church. I'd like to take this time to acknowledge my spiritual father who is here. I'm so honored to have him today. We haven't had him for a while. We haven't had time to speak in front of him for a very long time. He's been busy doing the work of God, and also growing the work of God. Also, I want to acknowledge the pastor of this house, Pastor Lenny, and also his wife, Tina. Thank you for the opportunity. And also, CIA leaders, Akabe and his wife, Lo, thank you for the invitation. I'm honored. I'm nervous, too. I've never been nervous. So nervous just to speak in front of a great church. I love our church. I love doing church. I love working with young people. And I love just being a part of Gateway. Hallelujah. It's a special place. It's an awesome place to be. And I'd like to firstly welcome you. Those who are visiting, I'd like to welcome you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I hope that you be blessed by our service this morning. Amen. Everything we do, it's according to the will of God. Amen. What we do in this life, what we do in the body of Christ, yes, it's because of one thing. And I wanted to bring it to us this morning. Vision. Amen. Vision. Amen. I've always had this heart for vision. Every time I will preach, I want to cast vision. Amen. Why? Because there is a vision for the house. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. And this theme is heart for the house for this month. But I don't know about you, but the house has a heart. Yeah. And if the house has a heart, that means it has a pulse. In other words, it's alive. The house of God, the body of Christ, it's alive. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And the beat of a pulse goes, do-doom, do-doom, do-doom. That tells us we have a rhythm. Yes. Gateway Vision has a rhythm. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We carry that rhythm. Yes. And the vision is to be a magnificent church, impacting generations with the love of Christ and through the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Yeah, rhythm. We have a sound. We have something to carry. Without the Proverbs tells us, without a vision, there is no direction. But blessed is the man that yields to the Lord. Hallelujah. When we talk about law, we're talking about boundaries. There are laws inside the house. Vision has laws. Vision have boundaries. Vision have some kind of, it's a place where you cannot go over the boundary. Hallelujah. And that's what vision does to us. When we cast our vision, it tells us magnificent. It's our identity. Hallelujah. Magnificent is our identity. We need to eat magnificent, sleep magnificent, wake up magnificent. Hallelujah. That's who we are. Praise God. And then impact generation. You cannot impact generation if your life is not increasing in the power of Christ, in the Word of God. Hallelujah. We need to increase. To become a blessing to the body, become a blessing to your workhouse, in your schools. Increase. That's how we get to a place of impact. Hallelujah. And then influence. Hallelujah. See, it starts off magnificent, and then impacting, increasing. Then the love of Christ, meaning impact. When you show the love of Christ, people around you will become a blessing. You become a blessing. Why? There's an impact you carry. Hallelujah. People will see Christ because you show love to whosoever. Hallelujah. And then with the power of the Holy Spirit, influence. Impact and influence are two different things. Influence, it gives something, it makes, it's a person, it's someone that follows you. When you influence somebody, people will start to follow you. That's what influence means. Hallelujah. When you're going towards a vision, vision tells us we are going somewhere. We're going to a place. We're not just going anywhere. There is one place. This direction is for everyone. Hallelujah. If you like it or not, we're going to this place. If you feel it or not, we are going to this place. Hallelujah. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah. I want to talk to you about a man named Joseph, where God gave him a dream. At 17 years old, gave him a dream. And God had a future in mind for him. But then Joseph had to go through some certain tests. Just like what we're going through now. We have tests in our lives that we have to go through. But this test will develop our character in this life. Yes. Hallelujah. Why? Because I believe character pushes you to fulfill the destiny that God has for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And our theme for today is hope to destiny.
Wow.
Hallelujah. Hope to destiny.
Amen.
How do we get to that place? How do we get from hope to destiny? Hallelujah.
Amen.
How can we know God's purpose for our lives? Is it our jobs? Is it our career? Is it our business? Or is it just being a motherhood or a fatherhood? In Genesis 45, I want to read to us this morning. This is the first time that Joseph sees his brothers. Since they sold him to become a slave, to be a slave. And then now the Bible says he's 39 years old. Hallelujah, 39 years old. And they have had 7 years in abundance. And now they're going into 2 years in famine. And this is where Joseph recognized, when he sees his brothers, he recognized them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I want to read it to us this morning. Genesis 45, verses 4 to 8, and it goes like this. And Joseph said to his brothers, "Please come near to me." So they came near. Then he said, "I am Joseph, your brother, whom you sold into Egypt. But now do not therefore be grieved or angry with yourselves because you sold me here. Listen, for God sent me before you to preserve life."
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Verse 6. "For these 2 years the famine has been in the land, and there are still 5 years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvesting." Verse 7. "And God sent me," and it says, "God," and verse 7, "and God sent me before you to preserve a posterity for you in the earth, and to save your lives by a great deliverance."
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And number 8, it says, "So now it was not you who sent me here, but God.
Amen.
And he has made me a father to Pharaoh, and the Lord of all his house, a ruler throughout all the land of Egypt."
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Isn't that awesome?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we read today, Joseph knew exactly here in this very moment that God had a plan for his life.
Amen.
Why? Because 5 says he sent me. God sent me. Second time in verse 7, he goes, "God sent me."
Yes.
And then number 8, he goes, "You did not send me, but God."
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Isn't it awesome?
Yes.
See, how do we know and discover God's purpose for our lives? My first point, for our youth, especially for our youth, my first point is believe.
Amen.
First, believe that you have a purpose.
Amen.
I want you to understand, when you believe with all my heart, I know that God will fulfill the purpose upon your life. This is the number one question, deep down in all our hearts: what's my purpose? Does God even have a purpose for me? I want us to understand this morning, the God we serve is a purposeful God. He is not a purposeless God.
Yes.
He is a purposeful God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Everything he created has a purpose. God never created anything without a purpose. Ecclesiastes 3, verse 1 tells us, "To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven." Hallelujah. You see, God created trees. Trees with a purpose. He created animals with a purpose. He created you and I, people, with a purpose. One thing I'm trying to figure out in my mind is these insects. I don't know what's the purpose for these insects. They give me the chills sometimes. But the Bible says, for everything under heaven, he's given us a purpose.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, the best way to know God's purpose in our lives is we have to look within us. How did he make you? How did he make me? I asked my brother for some tools so I can do an example. So when we look at it, We're going to decide as a body. Please, when I bring it up, do not tell us the word or do not say the product or the object. I just want to bring out a point. Okay? So as we look to it, if you look at it, if we all look at it, we can realize what it's useful for or what's its purpose. So this isn't an object. Eh? But when I look at it, I'm thinking these are things that close and opens. So I'm thinking when I close it, it could be an earring. Yes? No. Or if I open it and I turn it around, it can be a gun. No. Or I'm thinking it could be a mic stand. No? Yes? Okay. What is this purpose? We all know what's this called. What's this called? Okay. We'll call it a spanner. In Australia, it's a different word. Okay. At least we know what's useful, okay? It does something. It locks and unlocks something. Hallelujah. See, the point is the designer had a purpose in mind for this. Listen, the designer had a specific purpose for you when he designed you. Hallelujah. Isn't that awesome? That we have a creator that designed you for a specific purpose. To do something in the house of God or for those around you. And all God wants is for you to believe. Believe that you have a purpose. Amen. Just to believe. That's all God wants for Adam and Eve. When he told Adam and Eve, do not eat of this tree. All he wanted as the father to his children, just to believe in my words. It's the same with us parents. When we raise up our children, all we want them to do is to believe what we say to them. There is a saying that says, experience is a good teacher. No, experience is a bad teacher. Why do I say this? Because when I tell my children, do not drink and drive, I'm meaning what? Don't do it. Why? Because the experience may kill them. The experience may come. They might come out sick and best. The experience, they might not make it because of the experience. But this is what I believe. Faith is a good teacher. Hallelujah. So all I want us to know, all that God wants us to know is just to believe. Amen. Believe that you have a purpose for your life. Yes. Praise God. Amen. Second, number two, belong. You belong to a purpose. Hallelujah. You belong to a purpose. CIA, Christian in Action. This is our purpose. We need to shine and live up to this name. Christian in Action. That's our purpose. If you don't know your purpose, this is your purpose. Live up to this name. Run with this name. Act with this name. Breathe this name. Hallelujah. Christian in Action. It's an amazing place to be when we know who we are. Amen. CIA, you carry a beautiful name. I don't know who named this name, but please, I want you to catch it. This is us. This is who we are. We belong to a purpose. Yes. Hallelujah. Think about it. Verse 5.
tells us, but now do not therefore be grieved or angry with yourself because you sold me here, for God sent me. Amen. This is Joseph to his brothers. And then verse 7 again, God sent me. Amen. Then verse 8, so now it was not you who sent me, but God. Amen. Hallelujah. These are the same people, the same guys that sold him to become a slave. And then he got set up and accused and he went to prison. But Joseph knew, you didn't send me here. God sent me here. Hallelujah. It was God's purpose for me to be here. You may not see it right now. You may not feel it right now. But I want you to remind you, I want you to understand that today God sent you here. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. It wasn't your friend. It wasn't your neighbor. Right. It wasn't anyone. Amen. God sent you here. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Joseph understood. He's got a plan. Someone has a plan for him. Someone has a purpose for him. Amen. Jeremiah tells us at the end of the scripture, Jeremiah 29:11, the plan was not to harm us, but to prosper us. Amen. We see in the life of Joseph, yes, he started to come, you know, in the ditch, and then he became a governor in the house of Pharaoh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But he knew in himself, this is where I belong. This is God's purpose for me. Hallelujah. We belong to a purpose. No one can derail you. No one can make you give up but you. Do not blame the person next to you. Do not blame the situation. Do not blame your surroundings. Blame you. Hallelujah. Amen. Turn to the person next to you. Get over yourself. Yes. Yeah. Amen. Deal with it. Yeah. Face it. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. It wasn't them that called you. God called you. So what if they say something about you? So what if they hurt you? We've all been there. But God sent you. Yeah. Hallelujah. Isn't it awesome? We ought to be excited. Yes. Hallelujah. Because no one else called you. Yes. My God called me. Yes. That's why I don't care if people talk about me. Yes. They didn't call me. Right. God called me. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Stop believing. Stop believing that, you know, you won't fulfill God's purpose in your life because of somebody else. Hallelujah. Yes. Romans 8:28 tells us, and we know that all things work together for good. Yes. To those who love God, to those who are called, yes, according to his purpose. Amen. Yeah. The only way from hope to destiny is living up to the purpose of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Because you belong to a purpose. Praise God. Yes. Even when things go wrong, I believe that God is working on your behalf. God is working everything for our good. Amen. Woohoo! Hallelujah. Praise God. Isaiah 55:11 says, so is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose which I sent it. Hallelujah. That's a beautiful verse. You know what God is saying? When I speak my word, it will never return to me void, empty. But something happens. Guess what? He has spoken of your life. Amen. Hallelujah. He has spoken over you and I. Something. We belong to a purpose. Praise God. God's word has a power to accomplish whatever he sends his word.
Amen.
Woo! Hallelujah. Praise God. And if we allow ourselves first to believe, and then we belong. And then my last point, build on the purpose. Build upon God's purpose upon your life. Hallelujah. Romans 12, verse 5, it says, so we, being many, are one body in Christ, and individually members of one body. Verse 6, having them gifts differing according to the grace that is given to us, let us use it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I believe with all my heart, CIA, God has given you a talent. God has given you a gift. And I want to speak it over you. Everywhere you go, your gift will work.
Amen.
I'm telling you, it doesn't matter where you go, God's purpose, God's gift will work. Hallelujah, because you carry his name. You carry something significant. But David tells us you are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Amen.
So you are unique. You were created for something. You were created for a purpose. We have something to offer. Hallelujah. We carry something. Praise God. See, I've seen a lot. I've been growing up in church. I've seen a lot of people coming and going. And that's okay. But we've all gone through tests. Sometimes it's the pride test. Sometimes it's purity test. Sometimes it's the power test. But one thing I know, with God, when you fail, you can do it again. You can pick yourself up and go again.
Amen.
Why? Because God's heart is for you to accomplish the purpose of God in your life.
Amen.
He wants you to take you there.
Amen.
He wants you to fulfill a purpose in your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
I want to finish off like this. We all go through things in life, even the church life. But if you're looking for a perfect church, you won't find it here. If you're looking for a perfect pastor, you won't find it here. If you're looking for a perfect leaders, you won't find it here. But if you believe with us, if you belong with us, belong to this purpose.
Yes.
Build this purpose.
Hallelujah.
I believe for my heart that Gateway will build a magnificent place, impacting generations with the love of Christ and through the power of the Holy Spirit. Can we be upstanding? Hallelujah. I don't want to let this opportunity go.
Yes.
But I want to invite you. If you need prayer, or if you have going through something, need prayer, salvation, prayer of healing,
yes.
This is your opportunity. This is for you. This purpose is for you.
God's purpose, He wants to take you there. Yes. It's never in His mind, in His heart for you to perish. Yes. But it's never for Him for you to perish. Yes. But He wants you to fulfill all that He has for you. Yes. All that He has planted in your heart. All that He's spoken over your lives. Me too. He wants us to complete and finish off this year strong. Hallelujah. So if it's anything you want to pray for, let us pray with you. Hallelujah. Jesus, we honor you. We glorify you.
One of the things plaguing our generation is people trying to figure out who they are. This is a song to our generation. We bear the name of the Father, and in Him we find our identity.
A brand new fit looking cool, check. I'm looking in the mirror like, ooh, yes. to cover for an insecure dude, check. But she won't feel me and they won't like me if I ain't in them J's or them brand new Nikes. Let's stick deep from inside my psyche. When it's all said and done, even I don't like me. He live in the gym and his hair stay faded. Late model cars so they think he made it. He's Christian, he gave his life, but he still ain't satisfied in the Savior Christ. Still finds his identity in looks and cars. If he only knew that he ain't have to look so hard. If he looked in God, it may seem odd, but he be so satisfied he can leave it all. Yeah. I'm not the shoes I wear, I'm not the clothes I buy, I'm not the house I live in, I'm not the car I drive, no. I'm not the job I work, you can't define my worth. By nothing on God's green earth, my identity is found in Christ.
Hey, how do I gauge success? What do I say I'm blessed? Huh?